Hello, everyone. We continue our conversation about the basics of classical massage. And in this lesson, we will talk about the mechanisms that works inside the human body during the massage. Or more simply, how does massage work? Massage makes changes in the function of our organs, which are not only under the hand of a massage therapist, but also far from the massage zone. Why it happens? The reason for this is that the organism of a living person is a whole, and any irritation from the outside is a source of important information for it. And regardless of whether these irritations are pleasant or unpleasant, repetitive, or the body facing it for the first time, in any case, this information is captured by our various organs, and the body must somehow react to it. So massage is exactly the same specific irritant that triggers the response processes within us. If we enumerate in detail all the organs and systems that respond to the massage, we will get a quite big list. But if we analyze and group all these responses of the organism, we will see that all the variety of responses to massage is provided by only three mechanisms. And they are the mechanical action, humoral, and reflex. Let's talk about them in more detail. The first, the most understandable to all, is the mechanical factor. It is always present in the massage, even with a very light touch on the skin, and it is a triggering factor for the other two. The essence of this mechanism is as follows. Any tissue that falls into the hands of a massage therapist, in one degree or another, is compressed, shifted, or stretched, in other words, deformed. And this deformation of the tissues directly affects the various microscopic fibers, cells, and other structures that form the massaged tissue. For example, thanks to a mechanical factor, the skin quickly gets rid of the cells of the upper layer. Vessels that fall into the hands of a massage therapist are also mechanically compressed, and as a result, blood and lymph are squeezed out of them with greater force. That is, everything that directly goes into the hands of a massage therapist is being worked out. And often clients, and sometimes even massage therapists, believe that this is the only mechanism that affects the body during the massage. But it's not the only one. The fact is that a person is not just a set of individual cells and fibers, and all the cells and organs of our body do not live for their own sake. Therefore, in addition to their basic functions, they must obey to various general tasks. And the body doesn't care where its cells spend their whole lives, in one place, or they have the opportunity to travel around the body, such as, for example, blood cells. For this reason, they must constantly be aware of what is happening in the body in order to react in time. And for this, the body has special mechanism for transmitting information, thanks to which almost all the cells in our body receive the hot news and are aware of the latest events. And during the massage, these ways of transmitting information are also constantly and actively working. What are these mechanisms? The first of them is humoral, or if literally translated, a fluid mechanism. Humor in Latin means fluid. Its essence is as follows. All the cells of our body in varying degrees produce and secrete molecules of different substances. The cells of some organs are specialized in such experts, and such organs are called glands. Here is a familiar example. Everyone from school should remember that if the body is in danger, then an increased amount of adrenaline appears in the blood, and as a result, all human systems are aware that the body will have to struggle, and all its systems will switch to fight or flight mode. So, this very adrenaline is a substance that carries the information function. Our body has a lot of similar informants, and they are a type of biologically active substances. This ability to secrete such molecules belongs not only to the cells of the endocrine glands, but in varying degrees to all cells of our body. The difference is that simple cells secrete these molecules not directly into the blood or lymph as hormones, but more into the neighboring space that surrounds the cell itself. This space is called the intercellular, and it is mainly represented by the intercellular fluid. Therefore, the name of this mechanism is humoral, or fluid. So, the molecules of these substances inform their closest neighbors, the same cells, vessels, and receptors, about whether everything is in order, and if nothing special happens, then the secretions of these substances into the surrounding tissues is minimal, and all cells live and enjoy their usual short life in normal mode. But if the body begins to have some impact from the outside, in our case it is the pressure that the hands of massage therapist begin to produce, then the quiet life ends. Cells subjected to this pressure begin to forcefully squeeze out of themselves the reserves of these substances and form their new portions, and after some time the closest and even distant neighbors are aware of the fact that we may have problems and something happens in the body. As a result of this alarm, capillaries dilate not only in the area of massage, but also on the neighboring area, nerve impulses start to pass better, that is, cells and tissues begin to mobilize in order to fight back if necessary. As a result, this mechanism includes not only massaged, but also nearby tissues. And it turns out that this mechanism is more advanced in comparison with a simple mechanical action. But this second mechanism has its drawbacks. The fact is that the concentrations of many such informants is insufficient to warn all the cells of our body, and especially the cells of remote parts, that the massage therapist began to apply his physical strength to us. And even if these substances were enough for all cells of our body, so long as these molecules would reach all the cells in the remote parts through our blood or lymph, or even through the intercellular fluid, and convey important information to them, the massage therapist would have finished his working day and with impunity would leave the office. That is, the information would come late. And in order for this not to happen, a third mechanism comes to the rescue, namely the reflex. Thanks to it, through the receptors and the system of wires, that is the nerves, almost instantly, in a fraction of a second, our brain is aware of what the therapist does with our tissues in the periphery. And the brain also instantly gives orders to various organs of how to respond to a massage therapist and his massage. So if everything is okay and the massage therapist works with a sense of proportion, then the brain is in a good mood and gives, for example, such commands. The muscles can relax, the pressure in the arterial vessels may slightly decrease, the breathing may slow down, and so on. But if the massage therapist begins to experiment, applies too much force, then the receptors from under the hand of the massage therapist will immediately begin to report to the brain that the massage therapist is going overboard, and the brain will react to this information in another way. It understands vessels may be damaged, that is, bruises may appear, there may be other injuries of soft tissues and undesirable consequences for the body, and as a result, muscles on the orders of the brain will tighten, fists will clench, blood pressure will rise, heartbeat will increase, and so on. That is, our body through the nervous systems gives another, much faster and even more extensive response to massage, and with this mechanism it may be that light hand pressure is a stronger irritant and causes a stronger response. To better understand this, remember our reaction to tickling. In some people, by the way, the last described mechanism may not work, which happens, for example, in some diseases of the nervous system or after injuries. Then, in some parts of the body, the answer will be provided only by mechanical and humoral factors. But usually all three mechanisms work at once. For those who find it hard to immediately understand all these mechanisms, let's draw this analogy. Imagine a situation when it rains very heavily in a certain area, or, for example, a large hail. The people who are directly hit by such weather are equated with those structures that have sensed the mechanical factor of the massage, that is, directly come into contact with it. These same people at a meeting with other people, or for example by telephone, inform them about what happened to them, and this method of transmitting information is similar to the humoral factor. In this way they are unlikely to inform everyone, but they will notify some of their surroundings. And finally, if the event is really unusual and dangerous, then soon everyone will be warned about it on TV or radio. And then in a short time, already almost everyone will be aware of what is happening. This is clearly an analog of the reflex factor. The difference between this example and what happens during a massage is that for an organism, any influence from outside, dangerous or harmless, pleasant or unpleasant, is always important information. And in any case, it must reach the brain, where, after analyzing all the information, the brain will make the right orders for all subordinate structures. Sometimes students ask a question. Why do all these mechanisms need to be understood by a massage therapist? Knowing this, we can influence the organs we need in cases when access to them is difficult, or on the contrary, in such cases, refrain from massage. Let's look at two examples. The first is related to the situation when the reflex mechanism of massage can harm the health of the client. As a model, we will have a conditional person with acute gastric ulcer, or even better without an ulcer, but only with information over the gastric mucosa, that is either with acute or with exacerbated chronic gastritis, which is quite common. So even a light massage of the skin and abdominal muscles, especially some of its techniques, reflexively can increase the secretions of gastric juice with a high content of hydrochloric acid, which, to put it mildly, will not speed up the recovery of our conditional client. Sometimes deterioration may occur even during a back or chest massage, that is zones that are located far from the troubled stomach, and, as it may seem to someone, not particularly connected with it. As a result, massage will not only not improve the condition of the patient, but may actually contribute to the strengthening of inflammation with the probability of development of stomach ulcers or bleeding ulcer. And now imagine that a man came for a massage with relatively minor complaints, and thanks to the massage therapist, he received new acquaintances from local gastroenterologists or even surgeons. I'm sure you will agree that this is not the best result from the massage therapy. Therefore, in this example, for the period of exacerbations of the disease, it is better to abstain from massage. Our second example will be with a positive result. The second model will have only a broken arm or leg, and this damaged part of the body will be encased. And we will not be able to reach the injury site directly without removing the plaster. But we can cause beneficial changes in the arm or leg we need by massaging either a healthy limb or, for example, the neck or lower back. And at the same time, due to the reflex factor, positive change will already occur in the limbs on both sides. As you can see, there is no cheating, everything is absolutely honest, scientific and efficient. And this is how massage works. If you like our lesson, support us by pressing thumbs up or sharing our video. See you in the next lesson.